Okay. Is he a tiny dog?
He's a beagle. He's a small beagle.
Oh, okay.
So we will get in the tank with the dogs.
Uh-huh.
Sometimes we have to do it in the beginning with some dogs that are a little bit more scared. Most of the time they do much better with us not in there if they can well. But we do have dogs in there that we literally are moving lights for them. Now you also saw her walk outside. Representation of what she can actually do. She actually has got, you know, she ambulates pretty well. First time that she came in here, though, she was on a sling. And we're like, but then she walked in here the next time.
Yeah.
Yeah. She can walk. She just uses not so sometimes. She really is nice and weighty. Yeah. Did a good job of her. I think, did they trim up her back end too?
Yeah. Needed it.
Yeah.
I tried to have them go a little shorter there. Because when she goes to the bathroom, even before her issue, she, like, goes all the way down. Like, she's basically sitting in it when she goes.
Yeah.
And then sometimes nowadays, when she loses her balance, then she goes all the way in it.
Hi. Say to the front of the belt. Good girl. I know the air conditioner's on. I'm sorry about that. And we have all kinds of different things. You see, we've got pool noodles. Well, there's probably about four or five pool noodles that have fallen back there, which I'll use them as bumpers for the dogs that just want to go.
No, Daisy.
We're not doing this. For the, you know, we've got dogs that just walk outside, so I can use them as bumpers. If I've got a dog that has got, I haven't had it in a while, but sometimes I will get it with the FCE dogs, that they're not advancing, only one leg, I will put the TheraBand stuff on them, so I can kind of pull the leg forward for them.
Mm-hmm.
Good girl.
I didn't even see Kim all day.
I was in this room all day long.
And I was in there.
She was doing laser treatments all day. I would go in there, feel a knee, okay, knee feels okay, and then come back in here. Well, let's laser them.
Wait, who's after her?
Rain.
Done.
I was rushing to get out of here. My father had surgery on, so I think I just broke an artery on Friday. So I was hoping to leave here by like 4:30, but wound up leaving here at 5:45 or something like that. My sister was coming in, taking a train to Babylon, and I had to pick up the train station so we can go visit my dad. And so literally, I was like,
"Good girl, keep going."
Rushing to get out of here. Does not surprise me if I did not print up right, because I forgot to print up Charlie and Lucky at the same time. I don't know how I pass over those two. Good job. Where are we? We're at 5.5. Can you go grab a chart, John, over there for me? And I have a time. You can tell me what time the breaks are. I've done breaks at, the first one was at 5. Okay, we're already at 6.
Good girl, Daisy.
Good girl. Because we'll stop her when we get a break. This is a lot of work for her.
Yeah, she's getting a little slumped in the back.
Okay, I'm stopping you at 6. Okay, take a break. Oh, and then you're down.
Go me. And you bandana.
Where did you bring her to?
It's right in West Babylon. Magic Paws.
Okay.
Yeah. Right on Sunrise Highway.
Okay.
On the other side.
There's one down in the town, too.
What's that?
There's one down in the town, too.
Oh.
A groomer shop. But good to know that there's one around here that will take dogs that can't stand the entire time.
Yeah, when I called, I made sure, I told them,
We're always on the lookout for places like that. Because she is not the only one that we've had to deal with us. And it's not just dogs that have got conditions like she does. It's the 14-year-old arthritic shepherd and things like that. They can't stand it anymore. So, speaking of 14-year-old, and actually he's only 12. What happened to Jack? He was all gung-ho to start again, and then canceled the appointment and never saw him again.
Oh, yeah.
But I'll see him again because he always shows up.
You're doing good.
Because G's patient. G. G.
Hey.
Rehabbed him. No, I did call her. I left a message.
I know, but he'll call me like, I need an appointment for Thursday or Wednesday or something.
Ridiculous. G rehabbed him through 2 knee surgeries, and then I got him when the hips started giving out on him.
Doing good, Daisy.
Are we ready to go?
She's like, no, I'm ready to go home.
Yeah, right?
Hey, Mama.
I brought my clothes in the gym, but it did last week too.
She just walked out of here for like an hour.
Some water, it looks even harder. They made G do it in the beginning. She made like 10 minutes, that was it.
Yeah, I'd probably pass out.
Jeez, for marathons.
Hi.
You ready?
Come on, Daisy.
Hey, come on.
Come on.
Girl.
Here we go. What is she doing?
She's just being Daisy.
Good girl.
Come on, Daisy. No, Daisy. Come on.
We expend more energy trying to cheat and get out of walking. Good girl. Good choice. Good job, Daisy.
Daisy. Come on.
She seems to do that when she looks down.
Whether I print up one for you?
Yeah.
Okay. I don't think I have Rain's chart.
Come on, Daisy. No, no, no. Come. Come this way.
We're lasering her twice a week.
Come
right
here.
Now. She's 3 weeks. No, 3 weeks plus not now. She had a TPLO on the right side. We rehabbed her for the first TPLO in December. So we actually had it for January. And she actually came in both more for us, so we did the one that she was weight bearing less on first.
Yeah.
Good girl, Daisy.
Good girl.
Come on.
Hit bull with the head. Head is so old. Comes in here, she's just like,
she's
her. Yeah.
Come on.
That's why I booked her with Scott, so she's not gonna care.
Yeah, she's not gonna care.
It's only one area we're lasering anyway.
Yeah. Yeah, we were lasering her the first time for the first surgery. We not only were lasering the surgical leg, we were lasering the other leg since we did have the procedure. So we're helping down the inflammation. The other knee feels amazing right now. And she's recovering quicker. She has a good leg now.
Come on, Daisy.
Girl.
Come on.
Baby's stupid breasts.
I don't want them breasts. I think Charlie folks on her. Not those breasts. She got us though.
These look like they're made. She's pretty clever.
Yeah.
Styrofoam.
I don't know who brought this. Those are Christmas ornaments someone gave us.
These are cute.
Well, yeah.
Doctor, yeah, available.
Charlie Phillips got us a big basket down there. Originally had towels in, but we had too many towels. And then she got us a life preserver. This is not a real coffee. Gigi's husband got us out.
That's
that picture? Yeah,
the
dachshund.
Oh, do you mean the shepherd?
Yeah.
And that's Charlie from this morning. The dachshund right next to him with the pumpkins.
Oh, yeah.
Come on, Daisy.
He had surgery in November 2013. Just stopped coming. 6 months ago, so maybe more than 6 months, 9 months ago. She was here every Monday morning. She got a new job and couldn't take out money. He's 17. He was totally done with rehab and like him. Every once in a while, he would just want to keep me on my toes and try to nail me when I try to put a harness on him.
No, no, Daisy, come. Come on.
Okay, when's it up? You take the second break?
10:10.
Okay, we're at 11 now. And she's like, and we're done. Hey, Rick.
Still me.
Good job. I like it better this way. We actually get things accomplished.
I know, right?
So I'd like floating. Too.
Trying to break your neck off.
Mm-hmm. I am so dyslexic today.
Good job, Daisy. I double booked.
We're having a brain fart right now.
Dominique does tomorrow.
I think with
Evie.
Hey. Hey,
you're
pretty
good. I'm shiver. The one that I said was fat, and the one I was adamant that I was lying to her. I can't cut her food down.
Oh, God.
That one. So she was not in the treadmill for that one. We did the treadmill. Maybe we can get us jump started on Goliath. Or unslung. I don't know if they're doing acupuncture again next week. Because that was very successful. Both those needles came out within a couple of minutes. They did the acupuncture in here. And yeah.
It's a waste.
Erin, please call 6-2.
I'm assuming if he was in the room though, or if he had, if she would have sent an assistant.
He did the same thing when I went in there with his acupuncture that one day when he was here. He did the same thing. He took them right out. And it was me and Domenica in there at the same time. Still, Goliath wasn't with us.
He is a 11 and a half year old bulldog. He's got arthritis everywhere. He's got some other issues going on, but no one really knows what's going on. He's had some respiratory problems. He didn't look like he was making it out of the hospital a couple weeks ago. He had pneumonia. He's pulsing everyone. I can't say he's grumpy, but he's set in his ways. You know what I mean? So if he doesn't want to do something, he's not doing it. He's a nice boy, though. And then she comes with her other 11-year-old, Pitbull Goliath, who's an absolute doll. Just Scooter. The baby. She came in.
Do you want to see what her regular vet's chart says? Mm-hmm. Your Squeaker? Yeah, you saw it.
Hi, Daisy. Hi, Mama.
This is in her regular vet's chart.
Hello?
This woman's crazy about her dogs. And in her regular vet's chart, it says, wife wants husband to think she found this dog at a gas station in a box. Because she bought it.
Aww.
Okay, yeah, no, this is PT Kim. Mr. Roland's on the phone with a credit card problem?
Who do you think it was?
Probably the other kind of thing. What is it, credit card?
Mama?
Oh, about how she found the dog in the gas station.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah. So her husband thinks that she found the dog in the gas station.
That would be me. That's... If I was married, that would be me. Yeah. I was just going to say I found it in the box by the dumpster. But now I work here, so I'm just like, oh, I found it was dished outside. Oh my god.
Yeah, that's actually kind of easy.
You ready?
I was a kid, I had a cat follow me home to school.
Oh.
Sort of.
You're right.
He followed me home because I helped him follow me home.
I never had anything follow me home.
I had a lot of animals follow me home, according to what my mother told. But then again, my father was also the one that would just come out to us and go, come out to the car. There'd be dog.
I don't think I ever found a dog.
He did a test 3 times. The last one was with my first border collie.
Are you ready?
Ready?
Come on, Daisy. Let's go.
Oh, what was your head? Aww. You don't have a headache now. Ready? 1, 2, 3.
It sounds worse because the glass thing.
I know.
The mirror.
I know.
That's a mirror in there?
Yeah, on the
this
other side.
The mirror.
Oh.
So when she hit it, it hits against the mirror. And it sounds worse than it feels.
Okay, so you're the second dog that's done that today.
Yeah. Sounds like they cracked their head. Cracked the glass.
Come on, Daisy.
Look down. So I feel like when you look down, it makes you get all.
Daisy, come here. Look. Come to me. Daisy. Come on.
Come on.
Is he
ever coming to do the maintenance on this thing?
He did the maintenance.
When?
That's why our water is up to 86 degrees. He did the maintenance a couple weeks ago. And we had the problem, he did the maintenance on that Thursday, and then the problem started that Monday.
Daisy, come on, no.
Did he ever call back after he canceled his appointment?
Yeah, I talked to him. There's only one guy in the entire eastern seaboard, for the most part, who fixes and installs underwater trucks. He's in Connecticut, so he can actually be here pretty quickly when we need to. Yeah, if you have a problem with it, sometimes it's the next day, and sometimes it's like, I'm doing an install in Delaware.
Very
convenient.
No, Daisy, come. Daisy, come. Come on. Daisy. No, no.
Good girl.
No, no, Daisy, come. Daisy.
So we have the last department you've seen?
The west.
Yeah.
Have you been to
all the other departments?
Daisy,
no,
come.
I haven't. Well, when it went to cardiology and endo. I was in the narrow for a little amount of time because I had my surgery done at school.
Okay.
Dentistry, I haven't been to anyone this week.
Mm-hmm.
And then I don't think I'm going to be in oncology. Well, I have a choice for the last 2 days that I'm there.
Okay.
In oncology. I haven't been in oncology.
They're amazing. Not only is she a BST in internal medicine, she's also a BST in emergency medicine. So she's brilliant.
All right, Reese, only at 101. Come on. Let's go.
96.
Daisy, come this way. Come on.
For a department, it seems like we don't do a hell of a lot. It is a part of your body. Because
mm-hmm.
we do a lot of this.
Yeah.
We also sit on the floor basically all day for the most part.
I prefer sitting on the floor now as opposed to sitting in chairs.
It is. It's weird. The first 3 months I started doing this, my back hurt.
Yep.
Just for sitting on the floor. And you just get used to it. And it's I'm more comfortable with coming out.
Yep.
Yeah.
Even at home, it's kind of scary. So my kid's sitting in her bed and I'm reading her story and I'm like, sit on the floor. She's sitting in my bed, I'm like, no, I'm gonna sit on the floor. I was printing out like some stuff, coupons and stuff, yesterday was Sunday, right?
Yeah.
I don't remember.
No, no, Daisy, come.
I'm sitting on the floor doing it, my mom comes
in. Daisy,
come
this way,
come
on. What
are you doing in the middle of the floor?
Come.
It's like, I'm just doing things. why is it strange? Like, if you have chairs and couches, and like, it's not important.
I worked in the rehab center in Plainview Woods for the first 2 years I was doing this. And we did mainly in-house patients, long-term in-house patients, like these big dogs that had had like neck surgery and they were down.
Doing it with Daisy.
We would have these dogs at the place for 6 months. And that last summer that I was there, I had 2 Dobermans, a Rottweiler, and 2 Bernese Mountain Dogs that I had to treat twice a day every day. To lift them and get them into the special slings for them and do all the exercises with them. Kills my shoulders. Yeah. I still get massage. I have to. When she first started working on me, the fascia on my back would not move. It just stuck. The other rehabilitator who I used to work with, Heather, she wound up missing right before I left, about 8 weeks, because she had a shoulder injury, and she's really hurt. Her shoulder just hurts. So we had dinner. We had about a month and a half ago or so. Still, she was young, still feeling like I'm back in physical therapy. Chose a green floor for in there because it was grass. And this is beach. So we should do that with the signs.
In the middle.
I stopped her 3 times last time, right?
Yes.
Okay. Did I get another stop? We're just going to keep on chugging here until you run out of steam because we're already at 20 and a half and you only did 18 last time. Okay, 21. Good job.